Welcome back. On October 2nd, Community School District 7 will kick off their health and wellness series for the 2019-2020 school year. Joining us with a preview of their first Zumba classes and different programs, we have Family Leadership Coordinator Timothy Coleman. Welcome.
Good morning.
Thank you. Always good to see you. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks for having me.
You know, so much in the Bronx is always spoken about when it comes to health and basically having an opportunity to get in shape. You know, it's great to be able to talk about this kind of subject, especially with a sports guy like myself. So, you know, tell us a little bit about your work.
So I'm the Family Leadership Coordinator in Community School District 7, which is in the Mott Haven section of the South Bronx.
Okay.
And under the leadership of our superintendent, Rafael Alvarez, and our deputy superintendent, Dr. Nyree Dawn Dixon, we've taken a different approach to parent empowerment. And so one of the things that we try to do on a regular basis is find multiple touch points for wellness. So it's not just physical wellness, it might be mental health, it might be how we started a community garden, right? So this Zumba class really came up because our focus this year is to get the parents to be the ones to actually lead all the workshops that are presented at our district office. So every week, Monday afternoons from 3:30 to 5:30, Wednesday mornings from 9:30 to 11:30, we do different types of workshops to engage our community. We oversee 24 schools that are 3K to 8th grade, represents about 15,000 families in the South Bronx. So last year, we started the wellness push in a very concentrated way. We partnered with a couple of community organizations, and we started our very first year-round community garden, which is actually in the back parking lot of our district office. The parents got a chance to choose the types of vegetables and herbs. We taught them how to take care of the garden. They harvest all of the herbs and vegetables, and then we do cooking classes on a weekly basis. So that gives us a chance to study folklore. That gives folks a chance to feel a true sense of community. And it also teaches folks how simple it is to substitute the bad things we normally eat with the good things that we now can grow and understand, because these are all experiential types of learning opportunities for the families. So the Zumba class is going to be taught by one of our parents from PSMS 31 over in Concourse Village. And so her name is Ms. Danielle Poole. So we put out a big pitch last year and said, hey, listen, you know, instead of hearing me, Timothy, stand here and lead all these workshops and talk incessantly about all these different things, why don't we just kind of tap into all of the great talent that we have already that's kind of undiscovered. And you'd be surprised. Parents, when they're given an opportunity and they're given the support to excel, they rise to the occasion. And we're using that to help change the narrative of the South Bronx. Ms. Poole decided, hey, listen, I want to do a Zumba class the first Wednesday of every month. And I was like, you know, here in the district office, that's pretty mind-boggling, because everybody comes to the district to complain about something, right? We also have in our district office floors 2 and 3 are for suspension hearing. So everything from the public perception of where we are could potentially be very negative, but we are changing that on a regular basis. So it's not just Zumba, which, you know, I'm excited to get in there and try. I mean, I think I'm going to make a total fool of myself, but that's okay. You know, we're going to get in there and do it. We've done smoothie and paint classes, right, where we just buy a bunch of fresh vegetables, a bunch of fresh fruits, whatever. Parents come in and they lead the classes. We have wonderful artists.
Timothy, what a wonderful idea to be able to bring communities together and have families working together. So, you know, obviously the goal of what you're doing is something different, but the actual process for doing it is also having change, having impact.
That's exactly right. One of the biggest opportunities that we've received in District 7 is through the My Brother's Keeper Family Challenge Grant. And so we use that. It has multiple goals, but goal number 6 is to engage the community in a respectful and trustful manner. And so we've taken the opportunity of having this extra funding, which we don't even have a budget at the district. Most of the folks that come to lead workshops, they're doing it for free. So, you know, having an opportunity to bring in, you know, a more varied type of menu of services for the families, I mean, we're having at least between 20 to 50 people per session show up for these workshops.
Unbelievable.
So when you talk empowerment, I mean, you have to really look at not only the demographics of what currently exists in the South Bronx, but what's the macro vision? Where is it that you're really trying to take the families? And in all honesty, I think it really starts with them knowing that they can trust you and them knowing that you're going to keep your word, because your word is all you have in the community, and knowing that they're going to be supported no matter what it is they seek to do.
You know, Timothy, we talked about it in the first segment too, you know, finding something as a vehicle for change and basically starting the conversation, getting people involved.
That's right.
Amazing what you guys have been able to do so far. So you talk a little bit about what you've done.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit more about what's coming up.
Yeah, so this year, you know, we survey our parents on a regular basis. And so through a new round of My Brother's Keeper funding that'll be active as of November, we're bringing our community members, they've requested American Sign Language. They've requested book clubs on specific books. We have one of our own published authors from within Community School District 7 who is going to lead a workshop. She wrote a book called Money Mike Wants a Brand New Bike. It's about youth and entrepreneurship. Her son, synopsis, right? Her son wanted a bike. He knew that the family couldn't really afford it. So it's about all of the different types of jobs that he took along the way to help raise the money to get his own bike. So she's going to come in and do a guest an artist in residence session with that. And we've done Tai Chi, yoga, wellness. We've also, if I could squeeze this in, we've allowed our parents to turn themselves into superheroes. We partnered with a company.
Most good parents are.
They really, really are, especially mine, Reverend Don and Reverend Ann Coleman of Lincoln, Nebraska. Shout out to mom and dad. Parents are heroes, but here's an opportunity for a parent to work with their child at the district. And create a superhero whose specific power is to combat a deficiency that they see in their local community. And so what we have found is that we call our comic book the Council of Seven, all right? And so any parent that comes...
It's going to be a movie soon, right?
Oh, listen, we are Avengers. Just going to bust the thing out. So listen, actually, going along with that, we started that comic book over the summer. So it's a published book right now. You can find it on our website.
That's great.
But we're doing, starting in January, anime classes. So all of those parents that participated in the comic book are now going to be able to animate those characters and tell just one piece of their backstory. And when you talk about bringing the community together, when you talk about educating children and parents simultaneously and putting them in an opportunity to learn and grow and experience education at the same time, District 7 is way ahead of the game.
Timothy, final words, and I'm assuming anyone can attend, right? Because
Absolutely.
You have all this stuff that everyone should be involved
It's open
to
the community, whichever community you belong to. You can find us on Eventbrite when you look up at CSD7BX. Register, join us, come with positivity, joy, family, and we'd love to have you.
Sharp dressed and
right.
Sharp message this
Thanks,
morning.
Man.
Great
Thank
stuff.
You.
Thank you, Timothy. We'll have to take a quick break, but when we come back, we'll have more open, so stay with us.